So October 10th, we have a provincial election here in Ontario, Canada. The just so you understand how the political system works here, we have the federal government in the same way that the U.S. would have its federal government, and then we have the 12 provinces or whatever we're at now, and they each have their own government within that that falls under the framework of the federal government. So we're going to be voting in Ontario, and there's two main parties and a third kind of party and a bunch of lower parties beyond that that are running. Currently in our system, the way it works is that the population is split up. I think it's about 129 blocks, the whole province, and each block has a vote and has an election, and then whoever wins in each of those goes on to form the cabinet of the provincial government. And normally it's one of the two big boys, or sometimes the third race horse, and that's the way it kind of goes. We've always voted this way. So what it means is, when you vote, you could say back the Liberals, and you want to see the Liberal government and the Liberal leadership in command or in control of the country politically. But the guy in your local area is a complete bonehead, and you don't want to vote for him because you don't want him representing you in office. So on this vote that we're coming up to October 10th, there's going to be a referendum, and the referendum is for to keep our existing system or to go with it's going to be called the proportional representation system. And how that would work is, we would have two votes when we would have an election, one for the local, our local representative to go to the big house, and another vote for the party that we want in power. So for instance, if we didn't like the Liberal guy here, we could vote for, say, Progressive Conservatives locally, but then we still want the leadership of the Liberals, so put them in power. What would then happen is, the main party or the top party would be made up of the representatives that have won across the area, who won each of their little pools, and up to, or basically, the percentage of the popular vote that they receive on the second ballot. So if there's 129 seats is what they're looking at the end, if the Liberals got 50% of the votes, they would get 64 and a half seats, and they would be able to control the government in a majority government. They would make up these extra seats from whatever they already collected and the percentage of 129. A little confusing, but basically what it would mean is that we could vote for our local guy, and we could vote for the party that we want in control. So those are our two options, that way, or just we continue on the way that we're going, one voice in parliament per local representative, and whoever makes up the party just from the overall province breakdown of little pieces of pie or whatever. We haven't had a referendum in a while. I can't remember the last one. Should Quebec be able to separate, or whatever the question was? But that's another day, another story.